Excited to be working on this lovely portrait. It's full of emotion, the tilt of her head, the body language, the expression in her eyes, all very intense, and it's a striking composition. It's in your face art. I will show you all my tips and techniques. Just stay tuned and I will show you how. If I can do it, you can do it. Stay tuned. Let's see. Some of the colors that I put out for this. Hold it up so you can see. We have our whitener black, of course. We have a dark brown, like a burnt umber. There's a tan, a pink, and a lighter pink. In the center, we have a red running all over, an orange, and then we have a purple and yellow. All that's going to go in skin tones and hair. That's my palette. So let's get started. All right, so working on the eyes first. First thing we're going to do. Get a brush that you can work with. This one has a sort of a point, and the eyes are big enough that we can get the detail in of this. Now, I'm going to use this to mix it on so you can see. I'm going to take this pink tone, put a little beige in it, beigey pink. Drop of purple. Drop more. Let's get some white. And let's go over here and make a little bit lighter shade of the color. Okay, let's take this middle shade and use it as the eyeball color. Very nice eyeball color, right there. Move over here, inner eyeball. Very nice. And the top of the eyeball is always darker. And the pinkish tones are the reflections and the blood vessels in the eye. And the reflections of the skin, surface around it. Okay, now we're going to get a little bit more red. Stick it in there. Like that. And then in here we have a more reddish tone in there. Here. And we're just getting color down, you know, that's the first thing we do is just put color down. Like I always say, it's like being a writer, you got to get something on the page before you can start editing and improving it. So I think we're going to give her some nice big brown eyes. And a lot of these tones are going to be kind of sepia, and then this is going to be like more of a brownish instead of the stark black. Maybe we'll put a little purple in there too. Okay, so we're going to get a lighter pink color. Put a little white in it. More white. Alright. So, as the eyeball rounds around, you need the lighter color to show that it is rounded. So put that in. Not over the whole thing, but just like in the center. Okay. Now we're going to get a little bit of orange. And let's see, we'll stick it over in here. this is going to go on her lids. Now, as those lids round around, this part's going to be darker. So let's get a little bit of brown. Let's get in that orange. Put that. Let's see, as it rounds around, to show the depth, the curve. You need to show the curve. Putting in the highlights in her eye. It's definitely like a ring, some kind of ring light, which gives that round effect. And maybe right down here, since the white's sunk in, we're gonna maybe even go into the eye a little bit. Shows it could be wet. Going in like that. Okay. Now the forehead, I mixed up a pink tone. And I put that all in the center. Like so. And just blend it out. Kind of make it look rounded because the center of the forehead juts out more. Then we're going to take a little bit of brown, put it in there, mix with some red. Not too much red. Let's see. Get some yellow in there. Tone it down a little. And that's the color over here. And then maybe up along the hairline. And up here. Down around the side of the forehead. Putting in those tones. And comes over. And front of the nose. Now get a big soft brush. And blend. Blend it out. Okay. Now the eyebrows, I put in the brown with the purple, a little more red in there. Gives it a better brown tone. And then just feather them up. And then we're going to do individual hairs a little bit later. There we go. Very pretty. And then I think I'm going to take the same color. It's down around here. It's going to start. It's not having as much light, so we have to put in these very unique shadows on her face to give it that mood that we're trying to achieve, the mood. Now I'm going to take some beige, we'll have a couple little hairs for now. Just rough it up a little. There we go. Same over here. Oops, too much. Now, what I think I'm going to do is use up some of these paints. I'm going to take this red. And put this brown in it. Some black. And just fill in the background. We have this orangish brown. Now I'm going to lighten it up a little white. Start working in here. Up into the eyebrow. Now I'm going to take some, this reddish brown color, mix some black in with it and get it really dark. And to perk it up a little, we're going to put some orange tones in. This is going to go down the side of our nose. Put a very light light coat, watered down, get that darker tone in there. Orange in it. This light fleshy color. Some of that right there. And blend it. And then in the here you're gonna be able to see like some of her skin through it. So we are putting in the same flesh tone to make little hairs. Alright. Keep it the same. This is too light right here. Let's tone it down. Now I'm going to go a little bit darker. And let's see, put a little red on. Take a look. I am happy with it. Very pleased how it came out. It's full of emotion and just the look in her eyes. She looks so sad. You wonder, what is she thinking? And tilt of her head is also very sad too. It's just all in the body language and the eyes that makes it full of emotion. So I hope you guys had fun watching me. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Until next time, keep on practicing. Bye-bye.